That's not funny. Hey there, it's Elena, and I'm a nuclear physicist, and today we're going to be talking about a very hot topic. It is nuclear explosions and how you can survive them in case it happens in your region. Hopefully it will not, but it's nevertheless good to have the information. So there's mainly three things you should be aware of in case of a nuclear explosion or a nuclear attack, and that is what to do in case if you are outside and it happens. Secondly, in case if you are in your house or you manage to get in a building, and what to do from there on. And once you are inside and staying there, what to do from there. So when it comes to nuclear explosions, it's not just about the radiation. What we usually hear is the radiation is the scariest part, and of course it is, because it's lasting, it's long lasting, and it doesn't just fall on the ground and disappear. However, there is other things that one has to be mindful of, and that is, for example, the blast of the explosion, so the light that can cause eye damage, or even the sound from the explosion and the wave, and fires that can happen because of the explosion, electromagnetic pulses that can cause problems that we are going to discuss later on, as well as, of course, the radioactive fallout. So it is important, first off, in case you have heard from your authorities or you have actually seen in your region that a nuclear explosion or a nuclear attack is happening or is about to happen, then it is important you get inside the building as soon as possible. Even if you are outside the moment that the explosion happens, you are aiming to get inside a building as quickly as possible. I know it is very tempting to try and look back and see what's happening or see the mushroom or the blast, but do not do so, because of the blast and because of the heat and the brightness, your eyes can get damaged, and anything from temporary blindness to permanent blindness and everything in between can actually happen. So do not get tempted, just keep running, get inside the building and close the doors. It is important that you are as much as you can in the center of the building. Of course, preferably you are in the basement, that preferably also has a shelter. For example, here in Sweden, almost all buildings have allocated bomb shelters in the basement, where they are getting opened and prepped by the government in case a nuclear attack or an explosion is about to happen or a threat is basically out there. So if that is something that your country has, it is good to check it out and know the locations you can go and shelter yourself from such an attack. It is important also to shut the windows and shut the doors. Do not let anything be open, exactly for that reason, because the radiation is actually being stopped through different material and barriers that it passes through. So the more barriers between you and the explosion, the more safer you are. If you are, of course, exposed in the middle of the street and it happens, you are as much exposed as you can be. The more barriers in between, the better. When you are in a house or in your shelter, you would want to remove your clothing if you were outside the moment the explosion happens, because your clothing might be contaminated by the radiation fallout or by pieces from the explosion or the bomb that fell on you or in the area you were. And this kind of contamination doesn't really go away. So it will stay there and it might also travel through your skin and through your body, and you do not want that. So preferably, if you can, you're in your house or in the basement, remove your clothing and take a shower. Do not necessarily rub intensely your skin in case there is radiation on the surface, but just take a clean shower without really rubbing, but rinsing very nicely your skin and dabbing with a towel. When it comes to the second point, if you have managed to enter a building, and as we said, preferably a basement, this is what you should do once you are inside, and as we said, have removed your clothes and have taken a shower. So you should stay for at least 24 hours inside the building and listen to the news or to the radio to see what your government suggests you to do. Do not go outside, even if you think it might be safe, or even if you think that you need to check something, or you just want to see how things are in case you haven't heard from people. It is important to have, of course, food with you, and that you can perhaps plan with some food that is, how do you say, the food in can. Okay. Do not meet with family members that perhaps were in another house or in another apartment or in another place when the explosion happened. Do not go outside and try to meet or reunite with them. Shelter yourselves separately and reunite once it is okay, or once the radiation is not as high for you to be safe to go outside and meet other people. Same goes for pets. Your pets should be inside the house or in the shelter with you, not roaming around and coming back to the shelter, because they can pick up radiation and then basically harm themselves and the people in the shelter. So when it comes to the third point now, once you are inside the shelter and you have stayed there for 24 hours or even longer if your government does not suggest you to leave the shelter, it is important to have with you battery-powered devices. Why that is important is because one of the implications that a nuclear explosion can cause is an electromagnetic wave, which can actually affect all the electronic devices such as laptops, phones, even internet connections. So you might even have a device but not be able to connect to the internet to see what's going on or talk with someone. So it is important to have a radio, a battery-powered radio, and you can have that in your bag together with, as we said, some canned food or some water that can go downstairs with you in the basement, and from that you can hear to news or you can hear to your government's advice and announcements regarding the situation. Also, it is important to have a flashlight, because especially in the basements it can get dark or things can be the light might not work properly because of the explosion and we don't really know the extent of it. So for example, what I have is a flashlight that looks like that. So it's a battery powered flashlight and you just lift it up and it flashes like that, and when you close it down, it's basically closing itself. It's very good, it's very handy. You can carry it around, your kids can carry it around in case something happens and you need to have a flashlight with you. So summing up what we have discussed, it is important if you are outside, firstly, to seek a shelter. Do not look at the nuclear explosion. Try to go inside the building, remove your clothing and take a shower in case you are contaminated. Secondly, once you are inside the basement, do not try to go outside to look for other people. Remain there until your government tells you it's appropriate to go outside. Thirdly, it is important to have battery-powered devices with you, like a radio or the flashlight that we discussed, so you can have some light in the basement and also listen to the news from the outside world. And those are three ways you can stay safe during a nuclear attack that happens in your region. Don't forget to share this with your friends and family so you can all stay safe. I really do hope this does not happen anywhere in the world. Don't forget to like this video, leave a comment below with any questions you might have regarding this topic, and I'll do my best to try and answer all of them. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed already. This has been Alina, your friendly nuclear physicist, and until next time, see you soon. When